Wyndham Lewis's great misfortune was to fail to produce what was indisputably one of the kind of great modernist works in that way, to produce a work that people could batten on to, like The Wasteland or like Ulysses in literature, or in painting, to come up with a single defining canvas in the way that, say, Picasso did with Guernica, or even some of the Paul Nash paintings from the First War, which have a much stronger impact, I think, and presence, particularly in the English psyche. So that's one problem. There's no obvious sort of chef d'oeuvre for Wyndham Lewis, but that's of a part with his approach. His approach is a complete praxis. You know, he makes art, whether it be literature or painting, he makes essays, he makes philosophical treatises, he constantly adjusts and adapts his own aesthetic. He takes seriously the idea of modernism as a permanent artistic revolution taking place on many, many different fronts as well. And what you see with his close contemporaries, you know, he's born the same year as Joyce, is that Joyce's project is Joyce. Joyce is always convinced, which is incredibly unusual for an artist, of his own genius. And so the Joyce Project becomes the Joyce Project. Eliot retreats into the apparent certainties of high Anglicanism and the English establishment. So in a sense, his modernist project becomes anterior to his political project. And what you see is that modernism as a whole dissipates as a movement. People kind of call a halt to modernism. And I would argue that Wyndham Lewis is one of the real victims of that. You know, his disregard now is more a function of our own problems with what we think art is and how art has evolved in the second half of the 20th century and now into the 21st century than it is the quality of Lewis's work itself.